Every time there's a mass shooting or a mass killing, you always wonder, why didn't someone recognize that the shooter had a problem, someone in his family, and stop him? Well, there were certainly plenty of signs in Levi King's background. Levi King was showing antisocial behavior when he was very young. He was setting fires and killing animals, and he did go to several psychiatric institutions. I'm just going to read a little bit of some things that appear in his record. 6 years before he ever walked into Robin Doane's house. Here's one. October 24th, 1999. He tells doctors that he wants a gun and a pen because he wants to write a suicide note. Levi tells the doctors that he's hearing voices on the phone that aren't there. He says he's in the hospital because of drug abuse. Asked what drugs, he replies, more than you know. This is 6 years before he goes to Robin Doane's home. He is diagnosed with psychosis, probably manic depressive, manic type. Then November 29th of that same year, he's been hearing voices for a long time, according to this record, since age 11. He has said he's tried to kill himself several times. And according to this record, he is still barely able to hold a conversation. And yet, later on, he's out. He burns down a neighbor's home after he burglarizes the house. He's sentenced to 14 years, and despite this whole background, he's sent to a halfway house just 3 years into that sentence. And that's why he's free to be able to go to Robin Doane's house, kill her entire family, in September 2005.